This video is going to be a comparison between two phono cartridges, the Audio-Technica AT3600L and the Rega Carbon. The AT3600L sells on eBay, shipped to you directly from China, for around $11.65 as of when I'm making this video, plus $1.49 for shipping, and the Rega Carbon sells for $65. Now, it's no secret that the Rega Carbon is based on the AT3600. But the question is it really any different other than the name that's printed on the stylus and this fancy plastic case, the top of which doubles as a magnifier? Well, the AT3600 just comes in a plain plastic bag, although they do give you the mounting hardware and a stylus protector. It was kind of funny when I had the AT3600L shipped from China. The description they wrote on the package says, iron triangular moving pin. Okay, well, kind of sort of describes what a phono cartridge and stylus is. And if you look at the top of the AT3600L, it says right on it, made in China. But so does the Rega Carbon. The Rega Carbon comes equipped on three models of Rega turntables. The Rega Planar 1, which sells for $475. The Planar 1 Plus, which sells for $595. And the Rega Planar 2, which sells for $675. And on those turntables, audiophiles have been raving about the sound quality of the Rega Carbon cartridge.
We all know that the 2M-Rate on the Project's debut Carbon has an elliptical stylus, while the Rega Carbon and the Sony's cartridge each has a spherical stylus. But again, dear friends, having a finer stylus, more expensive cartridge does not mean better, high fidelity sound quality. Details and harmonics are clearly much better resolved and showcased by the Rega deck than the Project's deck. And the difference is night and day, about 70 to 80% in fact.
But can you get that same great audio quality on a phono cartridge that costs around $11? That's what I'm going to try to find out in this video. So there's really nothing to unbagging the Audio-Technica, but let's unbox the Rega Carbon, because it comes in this very stylish plastic box here. With a foam padding in there. I think it's actually twist tied to that, and they give you the mounting hardware. It's actually bolted to the foam. That's funny. And they give you a little pamphlet in here, along with a little Allen wrench to install the hardware. It says it's a high quality moving magnet pickup cartridge designed to be simple to set up, easy to install, and above all, accurately reproduce music. They don't give many specifications for the Rega Carbon, basically just tracking force of 2 to 3 grams, and it should have an output of 2.5 millivolts at 1 kilohertz. And they show how the wiring is. And the same thing in French. Audio-Technica publishes full specifications for the AT3600L. They say it has an output of 3.5 millivolts, and it has a recommended tracking force of 3.5 grams with an acceptable range of 2.5 to 4.5 grams. They both have a 0.6 mil bonded conical diamond stylus on a carbon fiber reinforced ABS plastic cantilever, and some sources claim that the Rega Carbon is a modified Audio-Technica cartridge.
Rega donning the Planar 1 with a modified Audio-Technica cartridge.
But the question is, how modified is it besides the name that's printed on the front of the stylus? Because otherwise, as far as the naked eye can see, they appear to be identical. I'll be mounting them on these American Audio turntable head shells, vaguely Technic style. This one is still in the bag while this one has been used, but otherwise they are identical. And the turntable I'll be using is my Audio-Technica ATLP120. I bought this new in 2010, and I've done some modifications to it. I removed the internal preamp, and I just installed the upgraded anti-skating spring, which you can order from Audio-Technica for $1 plus shipping. Cost about $8 and change, because LP120 turntables made before 2017 have a weak anti-skating spring, which does not apply enough anti-skating force even when you turn it all the way up. Audio-Technica fixed that problem on new LP120 turntables made as of the beginning of 2017, and you can order the spring to retrofit into older ones, which I just did. It's a rather involved process, but I'll link to a page which has step-by-step photos which make it as easy as possible, although it is still not really for a beginner to do. And here's the preamp I'm using. It's the Art Accessories DJ Pre 2, which gets very good reviews. And I'll be recording the audio samples using the Realtek HD Audio of my U310 keyboard PC in 16-bit 48 kHz sampling rate uncompressed wave files. And the video uploaded to YouTube will also have uncompressed audio. So the only audio compression will be that of YouTube itself. Just so I don't get them mixed up, I took a magic marker and I drew a black dot on the bottom of the Rega Carbon. That way I can tell the difference between the two, even if I happen to remove the stylus from them. Both cartridges are now mounted in their head shells with the help of this Technics overhang gauge, which I use to align the cartridges. For all the following tests and comparisons, I'll be tracking both cartridges at 3.0 grams, as checked with a stylus pressure gauge, because I found that with this turntable, the ATLP120, if you balance the tone arm and just set the tracking force using the numbers on the counterweight, it ends up being off by about 0.4 grams. So I always double check it with a gauge, just to make it as exact as I can. And on both of them, I have the anti-skating set to the corresponding value. And since I retrofitted the improved anti-skating spring, it actually works correctly on this turntable now. I've checked it using a laser disc, and once I get this set to the matching value for the tracking force, the stylus stays stationary and does not drift towards the center, which means the anti-skating is working accurately on this turntable now. Later in the video, I'll have some audio samples of both cartridges, but first I wanted to perform some objective measurements using the Ultimate Analog U Test LP, which will allow me to test the output level, frequency response, and stereo separation of both cartridges. I have the phono preamp set to a gain of negative 3 dB, which will stay the same for both cartridges, as well as the input level adjustment of my computer's sound card. I've already played about an hour's worth of music from various records on both phono cartridges to give them some time to break in. The first track on the test record is a steady 1 kHz tone for 2 minutes, which allows me to compare the output level of the two different cartridges. And in this screenshot here, what is shown as the left channel is the AT3600L, and what is shown as the right channel is the Rega Carbon. And remember, the Audio-Technica has a rated output level of 3.5 millivolts, while the Rega Carbon's rated output level is 2.5 millivolts. And indeed, in this test, the Audio-Technica does have a higher output level than the Rega Carbon. It's 0.65 decibels louder. However, there's a formula you can use to determine the difference in decibels between two voltages. It's 20 times log 10 of voltage 1 divided by voltage 2. So if we put in the two rated output voltage levels of these cartridges, 3.5 millivolts for the Audio-Technica and 2.5 millivolts for the Rega Carbon, we get a difference of 2.92 dB, whereas in my test, the difference was only 0.65 dB, which would be equivalent to a difference in output voltage of only 0.25 millivolts instead of the 1 millivolt difference in these cartridges' rated output levels. So that means either my Audio-Technica cartridge has a lower output level than it's supposed to have, or my Rega Carbon cartridge has a higher output level than it's supposed to have, because these two cartridges that I tested are a lot closer in output level than what the manufacturers claim they should be. Since that 1 kHz tone test was recorded in mono, that also lets me check the stereo channel balance of the two cartridges. With both cartridges, the left channel was louder than the right channel. With the Audio-Technica, the left channel was 0.66 dB louder, while with the Rega Carbon, the left channel was 1.42 dB louder. So the channel balance was actually worse with the Rega Carbon than with the Audio-Technica. Rega does not publish a channel balance specification for any of their cartridges, but for the AT3600L, Audio-Technica specifies a maximum channel balance difference of 2 dB. So in my test, both cartridges would be well within specification, and it's possible that the difference I encountered is simply the normal variation of what comes off the production line. The next two tracks on the test LP are a 1 kHz tone only in the left channel for 30 seconds, followed by the tone only in the right channel for 30 seconds, which allows you to test the stereo separation. With the Audio-Technica cartridge and the test with the left channel driven, the stereo separation was 25.81 dB, and with the right channel driven, the stereo separation was 26.47 dB. That gives us an average stereo separation of 26.14 dB. That significantly exceeds the Audio-Technica cartridge's rated stereo separation of 20 dB at 1 kHz. With the Rega Carbon cartridge, the test track with the left channel driven had a stereo separation of 22.03 dB, and the track with the right channel driven had a stereo separation of 27.07 dB. If we take the average of that, we get 24.55 dB. Of stereo separation for the Rega Carbon. Rega does not publish a stereo separation specification for the Carbon cartridge. However, in my test, its stereo separation is 1.59 dB worse than the Audio-Technica cartridge. Here is the frequency response graph. This was made using a test track containing pink noise, so it's not going to be a straight line across the screen, but it's still useful for comparing the two cartridges. In this case, the blue line is the Audio-Technica and the pink line is the Rega Carbon. They were within 1 dB of each other from 40 to 20,000 Hz. So I did not expect them to have drastically different sonic signatures, and indeed they do not. The two cartridges were very similar to each other across the entire audible range. So I thought that even if the two cartridges are fundamentally identical, part of the justification for the Rega Carbon's higher price would be if they were paying Audio-Technica to give them the cream of the crop, so to speak, to individually test units that come off the production line and only give them the ones that pass the highest specifications. But at least with my two samples here, that does not seem to be the case, because in terms of channel balance and stereo separation, the AT3600L was actually better than the Rega Carbon, although they both exceeded Audio-Technica's published specifications. And in terms of frequency response, they are both very, very close to each other. Next, I'll use the Shure Audio Obstacle Course Era 3 record to play the sibilance and bass drum tests with both cartridges, switching back and forth between them.
Sibilance test, level 1.
Mais que nada, sai da minha frente que eu quero passar. Pois o samba está animado, o que eu quero é samba. Este samba...
Sibilance test, level 1.
Mais que nada, sai da minha frente que eu quero passar. Pois o samba está animado, o que eu quero é samba. Este samba...
Level 2.
Mais que nada, sai da minha frente que eu quero passar. Pois o samba está animado, o que eu quero é samba. Este samba...
Level 2.
Mais que nada, sai da minha frente que eu quero passar. Pois o samba está animado, o que eu quero é samba. Este samba...
Level 3.
Mais que nada, sai da minha frente que eu quero passar. Pois o samba está animado, o eu quero é samba. Este samba que me...
Level 3.
Mais que nada, sai da minha frente que eu quero passar. Pois o samba está animado, o eu quero é samba. Este samba que me...
Level 4.
Mais que nada, sai da minha frente que eu quero passar. Pois o samba está animado, o eu quero é samba. Este samba que me...
Level 4.
Mais que nada, sai da minha frente que eu quero passar. Pois o samba está animado, o eu quero é samba. Este samba que me...
Level 5.
Mais que nada, sai da minha frente que eu quero passar. Pois o samba está animado, o eu quero é samba. Este samba que me...
Level 5.
Mais que nada, sai da minha frente que eu quero passar. Pois o samba está animado, o eu quero é samba. Este samba que me...
Bass drum test, level 1. Bass drum test, level 1. Level 2. Level 2. Level 3. Level 3. Level 4. Level 4. Level 5. Level 5.
Now I'll give you some audio samples comparing the AT3600L and the Rega Carbon.
Cheers. wicked is your soul? Your secret's safe with me for you. Fortunately, I'm the only one to see it's true.
So as far as I can tell, the only difference you get for paying $65 for a Rega Carbon instead of $11 or so for an Audio-Technica AT3600L is this fancy packaging instead of a plastic bag and the Rega name printed on the front of it. And Rega is not the only one to rebrand the AT3600L cartridge. There is also the Thorin's TAS257 cartridge, which they equip on turntables costing up to $1,500. The Stanton 300, which comes on various Stanton DJ turntables. And the Music Hall Melody cartridge, which you can buy for $75. I guess the extra $10 over the Rega Carbon is for painting the stylus black instead of white.